Councilor Palmeri.
Present.
Councilor Lombardino.
Here.
Councilor Zaccone.
Here.
Mayor Trentalis.
Open the public hearing statement, please.
The notice requirements provided for in the open public meetings act has been satisfied. Notice of this meeting is properly given to the annual notice which is adopted by the council on December 9, 2015. Said resolution was transmitted by the chief clerk and notice was posted in the council chambers of the city of Hudson.
Thank you. Discussion from officials, written comments, Madam Clerk?
None.
Citizen comments on the agenda, is anyone here to comment on the agenda? Okay. And, I'm sorry. We have these two gentlemen here, and we want to add to the record. This past weekend, and the weekend before, the township preparation department, in conjunction with the high school, had a series of tournaments to raise funds for autism. And I believe this weekend was girls softball, and the previous weekend was the boys baseball. So, we have our athletic director from high school, Zach Nascimento. We have our head baseball coach. Baseball, you're going to say something too. We have Anthony Strapp, our head baseball coach. Not the best year, but had a good year last year. This was a good year. Well, we lost a lot of seniors. And that's all the high school teams from us. So, if you gentlemen would like to say anything, this would be the appropriate time.
Sure, I'd like to talk a little bit about the tournament. First off, I'd like to say thank you to Mayor, Town Council, and Board of Ed for basically supporting the whole autism, the tournament and the fundraising that went on. What we did this past 2 weeks, this whole thing started, we are part of a autism tournament in North Brunswick, right? With Mike Lottie. So we've been in that tournament for a couple of years. What we did was we wanted to bring it to Weehawken, and Anthony Stratton and I tried to put this thing together. The cause was outstanding for autism awareness. We had a reception. We had the captains of all the teams and all of the schools that participated go to the Elks, and we had a couple of guest speakers. And the whole premise of what we were trying to do was trying to spread awareness with this disability being autism, but also we tried to speak a little bit about special needs and acceptance, okay? As a parent of a special needs son, this is something that was very important to me, so I have a personal connection to it. I was very proud to host it. I think that us, we as a town, our facilities, and the kids, and just that, you know, the bond between the recreation department and the high school, the relationships that we have, it's all very positive. So I felt very strongly about hosting it. It was a tremendous success. It was the second year that we did it. I think it's something that we're starting to get an identity for. I think a lot of people now are starting to know that, you know, something to look forward to in the future. The young teams and the coaches and the people that came, the fans were outstanding. The atmosphere was very accepting, and it was everything that we wanted it to be. So we decided this year, instead of doing one tournament with just baseball, we opened it up, expanded it to softball, and Mr. Callie, Brian Callie, is an employee of the school district, and he's a personal friend of mine. He's a parent of an autistic child, and he's also part of a group called POAC, Parents of Autistic Children. So what we wanted to do with softball was try to raise some money and then donate any, you know, the proceeds to that organization. This year we raised $3,500. It was a substantial amount of money for the first time that we had a softball tournament. It was awesome. I mean, it was such a great event and something I was very, very proud of. and for us to raise that money was exceptional. Baseball was a week prior. We raised $3,120, and again, that tournament was excellent. You know, we had some great teams, Red Bank Catholic versus St. Peter's Prep. We had Indian Hills versus, Indian Hills Ferris. We had some great matchups. So besides doing it for a great cause, we did have some excellent games, okay, that some of the better people around the state in terms of coverage and media came to and thought was an excellent thing. So I was very proud of it, very proud of the community. I think it was a positive thing for the community to be in front of and spearhead. And I look forward to continuing this year. And we can create our own identity, and it's a positive thing, not only for the school, but also for the town. And it's a positive reflection for our kids, spreading the words of acceptance and awareness with disabilities and autism. And it was really real. I was passionate about it because it is relevant, and it's a relevant issue right now. And it was a tremendous success. It really was.
Anthony, how many teams?
We had baseball had 14 teams this year. Next year we had 16 teams. This year 14 teams. You know, we were just talking about Mrs. Spinoza and Zach, how, you know, everyone thinks you just, all right, here's the game, you just play the baseball, you know, just play the game. But, you know, and I sincerely mean this, and I thank the mayor and the town council, along with the board of ed, and along with the administration of Weehawken High School. If we don't have that help, this is not good off the, give me a word.
What's the ground?
It's a great thing. He's a way to speak it tonight. You know, we have teams already that want to be, you know, we played, like Zach said, we played in North Brunswick. We played Metuchen. They want to be in our tournament next year.
I've already received phone calls saying what a great job, and can we join, can we be involved? Can we be involved with the fundraising concept of it, and what a great thing it is? And again, Mr. Spinoza and the administration in our school. It was just a great thing to be part of, very positive.
And just so, I mean, those of you that have, so we know, each team wears these jerseys.
Yeah.
With the dog team, everyone has their number on the back. And the other team, every team has a dog and a light, because that's a color of a dog, blue, light blue.
Yeah.
That's a kind of autism.
Well, so nice to watch. You had the autistic, some of the autistic children.
We had kids throw out the first pitch. It was not only, limited to kids with autism, but maybe a special needs teacher or a person that's affected or somehow connected to a disability. We did not pigeonhole it by you only had to have it. It was a very broad spectrum, and it was something that a lot of people felt acceptance with.
Anthony, you remember the quote when there was a preliminary dinner?
Yeah, the reception.
Up the
reception.
And represents all teams. Do you remember the quote? The lady that told you when her daughter or son passed out the ball?
Oh, the 23-year-old woman from Northampton.
Yeah.
She looked like she was so cute. She looked like she was about 16. So she threw up the first pitch, and we gave her a t-shirt, didn't have a number on it. So I said, you know what, I'm going to give her a number. Well, the coach is a personal friend of mine. So I brought her out a t-shirt with a number on it. So now before that, the mother had come over to me and said that was the most exciting moment of her life. 23 years old. So now I gave her a jersey, and I said, he's a jersey. And she said to me, am I on the team? I said, yeah, you're on the team. She said, I'm the first female player to ever play baseball for Northampton. We played Northampton the other day, and the mother came up to me again, and she called all her aunts and uncles and told them how she was excited about that. That's, you know, I get the chills talking about that. That's the best part.
What's really great, too, is the kids. All the teams showed up, all our boys in the boys' baseball, all the young ladies in the girls' softball, which this is the first year for girls' softball, right?
Yes.
And they gave up their time. It was a good lesson that, you know, give back to the community, and we support them, and they were all there, and they organized, and the kids helped organize the activities.
You know what was great?
I'm sorry. What we do at the reception is each team gets puzzle pieces, 20 puzzle pieces each. So when we go around for donations, we're going to donate signs that end in a puzzle piece. So at the reception, at the end of it, each team exchanged puzzle pieces. So, you know, I'm here, that's right, from Weehawken, Red Bay Catholic, we exchanged. And, you know, we posted them, we put them all over the concession stand.
Yeah.
And just real quick, just let me say something about throwing out the first pitch. The very first year we were in the autism tournament down in North Brunswick, we brought Jaden, we brought out our first pitch. Because of that, they now require every team to have someone throw the first pitch. And if you don't have someone, they have someone for you. So they have 40 teams. There's 40 teams in that tournament. Each team has a representative throughout the first pitch. And last year, Hoboken had the teacher of the year. He teaches autistic children throughout the first pitch. I mean, that's the best part of all that.
I went to the reception that this gentleman put together. It was an outstanding. The greatest thing that was said there is that these children, or some of these young adults even, for them to throw out that first pitch is such a milestone in their life. And we spoke to a lot of the kids, and you know, we told them that for you, throwing that ball, it's second nature to you.
Yeah.
For these other people, that's why you have to go out there and work for them. You have to play for them. So, and I would just like to again thank Town Council, Board of Education, and the Department of Public Works.
Yes.
Because they were so instrumental in making this thing happen. And these two gentlemen, as we had Anthony alluded to earlier about, you know, whatever you put on a program, the magnitude of this, it's a year-long thing. So they're already thinking in next year. So they spent almost a year on this program, and I want to congratulate the both of them and thank them but especially the kids in our high school and every high school have so much behind this program. Even our STEAM lab made those little puzzle pieces.
Jeez, yeah,
the one to that, you know, to act as a fundraiser that, you know, you gave a donation, you got a little puzzle piece, and we made them on 3D printers in our STEAM lab. The kids were volunteering in these concession stands, volunteering, you know, moving things around, getting the fields ready. And it was just a great community effort, and I want to thank everybody on behalf of the
I just want to say one other thing. The thing that stuck in my mind more than anything was to have the kids that threw out the first pitch, that was great, right? The kids that have a disability, you know, to give them that moment was great. But it was probably more affecting the kids on the team because they got to see and be accepting and aware of some of these disabilities. And that's the whole premise of what we're trying to do. As a parent of a special needs son, you know, my fear is, or my concern is that my son's always going to be okay, right? But you want to make sure that people are aware and accepting and understand that they're all people with disabilities. So the thing is, that kid had that moment of throwing out the first pitch, and I get that, but the thing was, it affected probably everyone else probably more so, because, you know, that's the message, spreading acceptance and awareness that there are some of these things, and that, to see the other kids on the team shake hands, come out, you know, the competitiveness was gone for a little bit of time. When the game started, yes, they want to win. But to see them shake hands, the atmosphere was so good, and it was, I'm probably more proud of that than anything I've accomplished as a football coach or anything as a player. So it is very proud.
Our students are so good. When we had Antonia in the school system before she graduated,
right.
And she was in,
absolutely,
actually a life machine.
Right.
She would be in the plays,
sure.
And the kids we raised today see no difference.
And that's it. Weehawken's unique in that sense. I've been in other districts, and the kids here, I would argue, are the best kids that I've had a chance to teach and be around, because of the community sense with them. It was an awesome, it was a great thing.
And I want to also add, it's probably an appropriate moment, I'm sure, here tomorrow night at the school board meeting. We have the president of the school board, Richard Barson, here, that in addition to all this, you had the peer leadership in the high school raised money for the homeless shelter.
Yes.
While the tournament's going on this weekend, we had peer leadership students helping out the seniors at one of our senior activities. And we had 12 young ladies there, young men and ladies. And in addition to that, the shining example is your students will report pick Weehawken, and they do their ratings every 3 years, and Weehawken came out number 56.
We have
56 out of 360 something high schools.
422 high schools.
So I want to congratulate the Board of Ed. And I know Richard, I know you want to add to that. And if you relay that tomorrow night, there was something in the national too.
1,700 in the nation out of 21,000.
Out of 21,000, 1,700.
I just want to say one more thing. So the kid Jamie joined the first pitch. We won that game, 1-3. So I called the newspaper, so I did coach, called the newspaper, and the age of the winning pitcher was. So I put Javen Navarro as the winning pitcher, he's 8 years old, so I put his name as the winning pitcher.
In the newspaper. Yeah.
In the newspaper. So his mom, his dad called me, and he said, you have Sheila crying. I said, why? He said, because she don't know if she'll ever see her son's name with sports in the newspaper. So then Javen says to his mother, you know, I'm the winning pitcher, and they said, yes. So he says, where's my trophy? Because now you got a trophy for softball. And so we're getting him a trophy, and then we're going to invite him down. And actually, we're going to get him a trophy, and we're going to invite him. I invite him down to practice. You know, and I tell my kid, you were upset about striking out. Well, I'm sure he wouldn't mind striking out. So we bring him down to practice before the autism appointment. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to get him a trophy with his name on it, and we're going to bring him.
Let us know when you do that. And Richard, again, our congratulations to the whole school system. And it was a great joy. And you know, and a lot of the DPW guys put their own time into this.
Yes,
that
yes.
Extra effort in. And congratulations on the U.S. Miss World Award.
Thank you. Actually, the last few weeks we're very good about this. But we're also, they rated the top 100 school districts in the state in terms of having the best teacher staff. We were number 34 in the state, so between that, Western World Report being 56, and Nationwide 1700,
Best of U.S. School Report, that would be ICAP.
Yeah.
You know, came in 56, and ICAP came in 79, and that's the pullout school. That's a big accomplishment. They're selective.
You know, we were 56, but it's true. There were a lot of very magnet schools that were ahead of us. So, at a public school, I think we're doing pretty well.
I think of the top 56, 25 are magnet schools. Yeah. So. And the total raise?
Total raise $6,620.
Again, Mar and I are our gratitude to the whole school system. And if the coaches would relate to the kids, we saw a lot of them today, some of them could make it. Just some of them were very proud, okay?
Thank you.
I think what's fantastic also is the fact that while all of the participants all are having fun, they're really learning at the same time. And they're learning a lot more than they could ever learn to read out of a book, right? Because they're learning how that feels and the experience. And that is a fantastic thing. And there's no more better reward than to have the children themselves thank you for everything that you all do, and we collectively thank you also. So from the bottom of our hearts, thank you.
Thank you.
I may want to add that I'm the uncle of an autistic child, and I say child as though he's 35 years old at this point in time, but one of the things I've learned by visiting, and this is, you know, the Bancroft School down in Hampton, was that these children want to have as much fun. These children want to be in the mainstream like anybody else, and their needs are the same as anybody else, and for them, the rewards of being able to participate, whether it's going to a museum, whether it's going to a library, whatever it might be, it's important to understand that their needs need to also be fulfilled, not only by parents and family, but also by a community. From that point of view, I really, really want to applaud what you're doing there, and I want to applaud also the involvement by by the mayor and his enthusiasm for that too, and Mr. Boston, the president of the Board of Education. Thank you so much for what you're doing.
Well, thank you so much. I mean, essentially, you know, this is the cooperation we have with the council and the Board of Ed. We've always worked together very well. That's the reason why I think that's the honor.
Well, I also want to thank you. As you know, I'm associated with North Hudson Community Action Corporation, and we have 11 health center sites throughout Hudson, the state, and Bergen counties. And in our waiting rooms, we do see children who are autistic. And Dr. Malamashi at our senior management meetings does tell us their efforts along those lines. And for you to contribute your time and have the type of organization you have is really a credit to you and your families for everything that you do for us. Thank you very much.
Just briefly, first of all, I'd like to congratulate the school and the Board of Education for doing the job they do to get our schools where they are, along with the teachers and the coaches and the principals and the superintendents, all who do a great job for our school and our town. And the other thing I just want to mention briefly is that when the mayor was outside, he talked about the kids giving back. And what I see is that for them to give back, they need an example. And you guys make a great example. Thank you.
And again, and that's what makes me all great. And it wasn't for all the volunteers, by the way, which are the parents and making sure everybody gets to where they have to be, and the grandparents and the aunts and the uncles. That's what makes our community great. So once again, thank you much. Please relay all our remarks to the school system, all right? Thank you again.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Play today, Anthony? I'm good.
You can't miss it.
Oh, it's good.
Did the girls play today?
Yeah, they won.
They won?
We lost to the girls. Catch it up to no good.
Track team won today.
What's that?
Our track team, we have this year for the first time, we have our outdoor track team. I have almost 50 kids on the team. We participate in the jumping events, running and throwing events, and this year, today was the first meet that we won, and we came in first place, so we're a first year program, and I was in an athletic director's meeting last week, and I was I received accolades, I guess, for our expansion with our outdoor track program. My boys' tennis program is going on right now. They're doing excellent as well. And for us to win, the track meet was awesome. It was at Seacaucus. We beat Seacaucus, Immaculate Conception, and St. Mary's. And so it's awesome.
You're saying track and field event. Is that track and field? So are we doing running or are we doing just the field event at this point in time?
Do all three events. You have running, you have jumping and throwing. So you have javelin, discus, and shot put going on one section. The running events go around the track, and then the jumping events, the triple jump, the long jump, and the high jump.
Waterfront field?
Yes, we do that for practice. We cannot have a meet there because I don't have a triple jump pit. I don't have
a couple things. Okay.
Which I didn't know.
Okay, I know. So here's the point.
Okay.
2 points. One, you know Stevens used that field, and they want the same
yes,
thing.
Yes, I do.
That we would probably, we had an arrangement with them. You may want to contact their athletic director.
Okay.
That we go 50-50 on putting the pit in.
Okay.
But I think they changed personnel and it kind of got lost last year. And also, when we do the Junior Olympics,
yes, I have my old team show up.
So we need your team.
No, why would we put that together? They're going on the 21st, I believe that is. May? I think it's May 21. And we're going to go, the whole team is going to go, and we're going to work it, and we're going to pick out.
But
we're going to connect that.
We want to do the pitch, so we have to bring it back again with Stevens. Something that.
I'm still new to this because it's our first year with this, but I would love to revisit it.
They always want to do it, and we found that agreement this year for 50-50, but I don't know what happened. So.
Well, some of the other athletic directors in the conference actually said to me they wish that we had an opportunity to run meets because we have the best facility in the state.
Right.
So if we ever did get some of those things put in, we would have probably.
The council remembers this, or Richard remembers this.
I don't know what
it was. The chairman of the committee, the co-chairman of the committee that set up the work with us all on the athletic facility down there. And the big discussion was should we put a track in or not. And half the committee did not want the track because they said we don't have a track team and no one's going to use it. Why are we making that happen down there? It's used by everybody for everything. We have other teams that are doing state practices down there.
I'm telling you, it's really the kids have grabbed onto it. It's an awesome thing.
But you know what happens when you see, once your season over?
It'll be over probably another month, because I have stage, I'm going into the stage.
Right, we need to do some work.
Yeah.
When, when, I'm 21st, that's the day for the Olympics. And Stephen's head coach will be there for a track.
I'll talk to him.
And then right after the season, we have to just do it, or else the summer comes and everybody forgets it.
Definitely.
All right?
I ran track for many, many years, so we'll be talking, okay?
He's been running track for 30 years, many campaigns.
I ran here.
I think it's a great outlet for the kids, and it's another thing that they can gravitate towards. And we have outdoor track. I had cross country this past season in the fall. I had boys tennis and girls tennis. We added four more sports this past year, and our numbers with participation has been great. Sorry.
Good.
Just very, very good.
One more observation. First of all, it was a really nice article in Bergen Record on the Chum System.
Yeah.
That was really great. And the other thing is, this is hard to believe for me. As a former weight man, I want to see the shot putting. When are we having our next meet?
Shot put, one of our kids won first place.
Now they use a 12 pound, right?
Yeah. Okay. Keith Hapless won first place this weekend.
I don't know what it is. Was that, you're talking about your weight?
It's a ball. Yeah.
It's a round ball.
I know what it is. You're talking about, when you said weight, was that carat weight or pass weight? Okay.
Yes.
You actually did shot put?
Yeah.
Really?
I tried. Well, we have a couple kids that do it, and they're football players, some of my football players. And like I said, Keith Havlins came in first place in the meet last week. I think it's just awesome to see all
the players. Do you have a tournament? Do you have a tournament?
But I can't host any track.
No. But what you have, that is stuff. Councilman's a tournament, my God.
Yeah, today we were at Seaport, because like I said, that would have been a good one because it's close. But
one last question.
We won, so that was the
most. I know that we have shot put, discus, javelin.
No. Okay. That's the only one we don't do. What is that? I don't have a place to practice that.
Okay.
I'm scared to throw a happy kiss.
And one more.
Yeah.
Do we have the hammer throw?
No. We don't have that anymore.
You know, Stevens used to use, I don't know if they still do, the vacant land south of the athletic facility.
For javelin?
I think, I don't know if they still do it or not.
I told the kids they're not allowed to do that.
No.
Because I was just nervous about the situation.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. Okay, thank you very much, Chuck. All right.
Thanks, guys.
Unfinished business.
Okay, so be there.
You want to take that to the schools or?
Yeah, but
leave it here, so we get it.
Leave it here. I'll pick it up tomorrow.
Take it tomorrow night. What
do you think of the meeting?
You want to take it now?
Yeah.
Or tomorrow?
Don't take it now for tomorrow next week.
You notice whose names are on the checks, signing checks, right? You notice whose names are on the checks?
Yeah, I know. That's
Mr. All right. We have two items to add. We're doing this with us in tomorrow. Thank you, Zach.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Great night.
Always going to be a tax appeal settlement for acquisition 300 more buddies. Do we have that on?
Yes,
definitely. Oh, no, we only have one other right there. Public access easement, 2304 Palisade, Enviro remediation. We have to give them an easement. This is the ongoing cleanup site for the property on Palisade Avenue. An oil leak and then spread throughout. So we're calling an item I would make an amendment to an ordinance? Okay, so it's introduction of an ordinance. And this will allow the cleanup to proceed. Okay? All right, so we'll do a consent agenda. I will read through the items. You tell me if we have to pull it off from a consent. And anybody that has a nay, so say it, all right? A is dedication by writing Uniform Safety Act. It's a procedure for funds we received from the state. B is emergency snow removal services. I think that's application. Is that our application to backs up our application to FEMA?
Yes, sir.
Okay. C is emergency purchasing of scaffolding. That's our Woodrow Wilson School. As you know, we have some issues with the roof area by Woodrow Wilson. We have our insurance companies looking into it, and we also applied for another FEMA to place after the blizzard. But this will pay for the scaffolding that the children that go there. Emergency garbage truck repairs, repairing garbage trucks is expensive, but we can figure that out. order of contract United States postage. There's no alternative to United States postage. However, the state requires us to do a resolution authorizing to spend money on United States postage. Don't even ask why, it makes no sense. F is TWA Henley Place, and refresh our memory, what's that?
That's a sewer connection authorization, consent to their application to connect to the sewers, a DEP application.
Okay, that's on the board. That's the Henley. G is the tax appeals settlement. H is reappointing rent board members. I will give you the names of the members so everybody's paying attention. Joseph Artigliano Jr., let's make sure we make that junior, guys. Raul Gonzalez, Kenneth Arena, Edward Nasty, Michael Capiello, Thomas Kralik, and Sandra Stocker. And alternatives is Joe Fiore. I is moving the public access easement I talked about, but that's an ordinance, so that's not going as a resolution, it's going as an ordinance. K is authorizing EUS utility order contract for Coteen Associates, and that is through review of our public
utilities, electric, gas, things and such. They'll evaluate how much you can spend, and if there's any errors on the ESCP side.
Okay. We thought it was time to do an NGO to see what's happening out there.
And there is no customers.
And it's free. It's even better. L is authorizing planning board to study area and redevelopment. This is Hackett. We'll do that separate. That's one board. We'll be separate. L will be separate. As everyone is aware, on the corner of Hackensack and Palisades by the Dunkin' Donuts, it's the last abandoned warehouse in Weehawken. It's the entrance to Weehawken on Hackensack, of course, means the post office. And we have we're preparing area redevelopment to try and encourage people to come in and hopefully demolish the building, build something new, as we've done on two locations further down Hackensack Front Road, as the planning board and the board of adjustment have handled. So this will start that process. It was a former roller skating rink years ago. I think it closed in the mid-80s. So, and it's an enormous piece of property. So we're hopefully, it's really an eyesore. So we're hoping that this will spur people to come forward and develop proposals. M is awarding a lien abandoned property at 603 Gregory Avenue, which I'll get to in a minute. And N is auctioning junk automobiles. Whole bunch of stuff. So we put out the auction.
Do we put it online or?
Yes, it goes
online auction.
The site is called GovDeals. It's run by, it's a private company, but it's authorized from the state.
And the date of the auction?
That, I can.
Undetermined.
They put it online and they.
So we have a whole, we have a whole.
We put a whole schedule together. It goes online and they tell us when the day is.
All right. Now for this abandoned property list, do we have to take action or?
No, we already do. Captains to do this are
public. So before I get to that, then let's do a consent agenda. I heard you. I'll say the numbers. Anybody has an issue, please so say. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. I again is the one to do the ordinance
separate.
Okay, so we take I off, that'll be a separate vote. K, L is a separate vote. M and N. No objections.
Yes.
Now we'll take a separate vote on public access agreement for 2304 Palisade Avenue.
So moved.
And moved Councilman Sebastiere, second Councilman Zaccone. Roll call, please.
Councilman
Sosa?
Aye. Councilman Sebastiere?
Yes.
Councilman Lapanito?
Yes.
Councilman Zaccone?
Yes.
Mayor Turner?
Yes. And this has been like a multi-year process. I think this has been going on for 3 or 4 years, so finally DEP has signed off what has to be done. So that will clean up that piece of property. And L is authorizing the planning board to do an area need redevelopment, Hackensack Plain Road.
So moved.
Second.
Moves the best error. Second. Zaccone. Roll call.
Councilman Sosa? Councilman Sebastiere?
Yes.
Councilman Lapanito?
Yes.
Councilman Zaccone?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. appropriate refusals.
There's one that I have to take off. Is a disputed bill for our tax liabilities.
Okay, what, so unit X is not part?
The one I posted, she wants a postage.
They're claiming a certain price for postage and we dispute with her postage price.
Right.
We're not disputing their service, we're disputing the cost of the mail, the postage amount.
So unit X will be taken off. It is located on the second page in the middle. All right, having said that, do I have a motion for the bill? Moved by Councilman Labodino, second Councilman Spencer-Eric, roll call.
Councilman Sosa?
Aye.
Councilman Spencer-Eric?
Yes.
Councilman Labodino?
Yes.
Councilman Cipollone?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, we have an announcement. Do we have to officially adjourn the WAUC board? We have to meet officially. But we have to meet as ABC. If anybody's here for the S&J Liquor and Deli ABC hearing, it's going to be postponed. We'll do that in a minute. All right, now we're for the approvals of the floor. Is anyone here to address us in any matter? Oh, let me talk about your favorite subject, abandoned properties. It's very difficult and a time-consuming process to deal with properties that are abandoned, but we are now going to take public notice and we're declaring the following properties abandoned, which will start a whole legal process. If someone does not come forward, the township will condemn these properties and take them, all right? Many of them have liens, as we know on them. So I'll go through the four properties. Owner of record for 191 Hackensack Plank Road is Francis Ortiz. Owner of record for 603 Gregory Avenue is Donald B. Giannotti. Owner of record for 592 Gregory Avenue is Justin Mastry. And owner of record for 67-69 Chestnut Street is Henry Miller. This starts the process. It's by order of Frank Rattoli, Public Works from Patrick Weehawken, and our chief construction official. And this will be published. Twice
and mailed.
And if we have no response, we're going to start a condemnation procedure proceedings on these properties. The cleanup will start next week with the yards and everything else that might even be at the end of this week, we're not sure yet. And if anybody knows, when we publish it, if anybody knows any of these individuals, you might think it could be to their advantage to contact the township manager or the building department. But we do not need a resolution on that.
Correct.
Okay, approvals of the floor. I don't care to address us. Mr. Ranturi.
Hello, all. Three topics.
Okay.
First, Gregory Avenue improvements. March 9th, town council said they'd be done the second week of April, or they'd begun the second week of April.
Well, I think we probably said on or about. I'm pretty careful that we give a firm date.
You are. I'd probably just say
on or about. Joe?
I spoke to the engineering firm today. They were going to confirm with the contractor. They got all their people back into the swing of things. I can confirm by the morning.
Okay. We would expect that. We also have an issue. We're trying to see where there'll be Memorial Day, because people have brought up a Memorial Day parade, and the worst of all is to have it milled and not paved. So we're trying to see what the schedule is. They will start the cement, I would imagine.
Yes.
Probably not going to change for a while, but that'll be short.
Thank you. Big topic right now is lead in school water. I'd like to know when our Weehawken schools were last tested, and where those reports are.
We detected up the last thing also. And we relayed our knowledge of it. The Weehawken High School was just tested a month ago, 6 weeks ago. And I believe the grammar schools have to be tested regularly. And to our knowledge, every test has come out perfect. But the best expert would be the superintendent of schools for that. But our information is they test the schools periodically and every test. And like I said, the high school was just tested a month or so ago.
Number three, the video audio guidelines for Weehawken.
I'm sorry?
The video audio recording guidelines for Weehawken. I went over them. They were very helpful provided by Mr. Bull. And in light of Terrace versus Borough of Pine Hill, New Jersey Supreme Court, 2007, the policy is, I don't know if you're aware, this is completely misaligned with the law, the current video audio guidelines. I can go into specifics, but basically, the board cannot restrict the number of non-obtrusive recording devices. The current audio guidelines says two people may record. If five people want to record, we can't deny numbers 3, 4, and 5 their civil right to record. Also, there's no right to privacy at public meetings. This is a public meeting, so a member of the audience or the town council can't say, I don't want to be recorded. It's a public meeting.
Well, we would never say that. The concern is some people in the audience, but you know, it's a little bit irrelevant because we never stop anybody from doing anything anyway, so we'll have the town attorney look at the regulations. We've had people in the past with 3, 4 people recording us. We basically put it in there, so we've also had people trip over equipment in the past.
Okay. You
know, we've had members of the audience trip over equipment when people get careless with it and
these sorts of things. Of course.
So it's kind of like a way that gives us a control, but we never have a problem with anybody doing so. And if a person's a local person, someone has, well, we say to people, if you have something very personal, you are being taped, you might want to wait until after the meeting to talk to the manager or one of us. But some people do from time to time bring up a very personal issue, which they don't realize it's being taped. So what about the town attorney?
If you like,
if you want to just give a copy to the board.
Absolutely. Because your current guidelines as they stand have several items that are misaligned with the law as it stands.
But we've never stopped anybody from anything anyway, so. During the planning board hearings over the years, we've had 10 people taping us. But then we would have mass confusion over equipment. Like I said, people tripping and knocking cameras over. We actually had a situation where the camera person whose camera got knocked over started arguing with somebody in the audience who tripped. And so it's just meant to control, but we'll look at it.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else? Okay. We will close it to the public. Now, I think we have to go in. We're going to meet as local agency?
Yes.
To postpone. All right. Do I have a motion to meet as local alcohol beverage?
Move to dispense with the regular order of business at convene as the agency.
Second.
Move that Councilman Sosa, second Councilwoman Silvestri. We're all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Now, we have scheduled hearing. ABC 1, Weehawken ABC Board versus S&J Liquor Deli, 3500 Park Avenue, license number, we have to record this one. License number 091-44-016-005. We were scheduled a hearing today, and I believe Mr. Benino, the attorney, called.
The attorney for the licensing gave us a day or two ago and called and asked for time to get the report together and prepare for the case.
Do we know when this will be? I prefer not May 11th, we have a pretty heavy schedule.
You can reschedule it.
The second meeting in May?
Yeah. May
25th? May 25th. Give them time anyway, because I doubt if you want to meet in 2 weeks. So you need a motion to extend that, or?
No, just a direction to the meeting.
All right, so we will extend it to May 25th. Any objections from the council? All right, but let's try and make sure that they're actually here, because we always have to put the police on call and then pay an expense. And try and figure out how to bill them for the expense, so let's try and lock them in. So, do we have to grant another postponement? This is the only postponement we have to grant?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so it will take place on May 25th, no, one way or the other, right? Okay, motion to leave ABC and go into executive session for personnel.
Reconvene as the Township Council and at the same time move to in the
executive session.
Second.
Move that Sosa, second, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
One other thing before going to executive session, I forgot. Approval of minutes from our March 23rd, 2016, including executive session. Do I have a motion? Move Lamanino.
Second.
Second, Sosa. Roll.
Councilman Sosa? Councilman Silvestri?
Yes.
Councilman Lamanino?
Yes.
Councilman Spoli?
Yes.
Mayor Turner?
Yes, my executive session will be on litigation and personnel. Okay, so thank you all. I don't think we may not be taking action when we come back. I don't know. So it will probably be a